Residents across Sydney are bracing for a late spring storm to hit the city today after last night's wild storms as well. Once again, strong winds will be coming through that will help clear the lingering smoke haze. Today, Sydney reporter Gabrielle Boyle is across all of this wild weather at the moment. Gabby, it doesn't feel like summer here is about to be hitting.
No, it doesn't. But we all know that a violent storm is Sydney's signature dish when it comes to weather. And that's exactly what we got last night here in Sydney, Tom. 28 millimetres of rain falling in some areas, and it came with lightning and hail and certainly very strong winds as well right throughout the evening. It caused 30 flights to be cancelled at Sydney Airport. Many more were delayed. But there was one group that certainly was not complaining, and that is our firefighters.
Oh, we're going to dance.
Hang on. The rain dance.
We're on a fire for Rowan's playing, isn't it?
Rowan's
playing. Rowan's playing.
But don't be deceived by that beautiful scene that you can see behind me, those clear skies, Tom. It's not expected to stay this way in Sydney. While we will get a top of 33 degrees in the city and about 35 out west, we're expecting more storms later today. They'll probably roll in around lunchtime. We could get a severe weather warning from the Bureau later on this morning, but it will affect Sydney, the Hunter and the Illawarra, and we could get winds of 90 kilometres an hour. So another wild day here in Sydney, Tom.
Wild day, but great to see the fireys with a rain dance and a smile on their faces as well. Gabby, thank you. Still on the fire ground, and actor Russell Crowe has documented his gladiatorial efforts to clear charred debris from his property around Nana Glen near Coffs Harbour in northern New South Wales. Now, this new video from this morning goes for about 2 minutes, shows the Hollywood star and friends hacking their way through the burnt-out trees and scorched bush there on his 400 hectares of land. And also that's a photo of big old Rusty's leg there, a dusty Rusty, showing scratches from his clean-up efforts.
A row has emerged between police and the bail justice who set James Gargasoulis free 6 days before the Bourke Street rampage at a coronial inquest underway in Melbourne. Our Melbourne reporter Christine Ahern has the story for us now. And Chris, the bail justice is now blaming police for the killer's release.
Well, Deb, he is accusing police of lying under oath here at the coronial inquest. Teacher-turned-volunteer bail justice Christos Pantalios claims that he was never given a document which outlined James Gargasoulis' extensive criminal history and bail violations before granting the Bourke Street killer bail at an out-of-hours hearing. This is despite lawyers acting for police producing that very document, which shows that it was printed out for the hearing, saying it defied logic that it was not given to the bail justice. In defending his decision to grant James Gargasoulis bail, Mr Pantalios told the inquest they, as in police, weren't making a massive song and dance about him being a massive danger to society. He did, however, go on to say that his memory from that hearing was polluted because of the media reports. The inquest continues today. Deb.
Christine, thank you.
Australians could be getting greater access to medical services at a cheaper price under planned changes to private health insurance. We'll get more with our political reporter Chris O'Keefe in Canberra. Chris, how much support is there for this shake-up?
There's a fair bit, Tom, and that's because treatment delivered outside of hospitals may be covered under private health insurance. That includes mental health and all the orthopaedics like knee and hip surgery. At the moment, your health cover only pays for treatment that happens inside a hospital. Now, the government wants to change that, and they want it changed by the middle of next year. The idea is to offer flexibility for not just patients, but insurers to make sure they don't just continually raise premiums the way they are. Truth is, people are ditching their private health cover because it's either too expensive or they don't believe it provides any value. 7,000 young Australians aged between 25 and 29 cancelled their hospital cover in just 3 months to September, but it is costing insurance companies more and more to insure older Australians who are using it more often. So both the government and the industry, Tom, know something has to change.
Certainly does. Chris O'Keefe there with the latest from Canberra. Thank you.
Green Senator Sarah Hanson-Young will donate the $120,000 she's won in a defamation lawsuit to women's charities. Ms Hanson-Young accused former Senator David Lionhelm of making a sexist slur in a debate on violence against women. She was very emotional after a federal court judge ruled in her favour.
It doesn't matter whether you work in a shop or on the factory floor or whether you work in the parliament. Every woman deserves to be treated with respect.
Senator Hanson-Young will be joining us here on the Today Show in around 10 minutes. The tragic deaths of two little girls found in a hot car in southeast Queensland will be reviewed by an independent inquiry after revelations they were known to the Department of Child Safety. Today, Queensland reporter Jess Millwood is across the details for us now. So, Jess, what will the focus be of this review?
Deb, it's all about finding out who knew what when in relation to the two little sisters who passed away in a hot car outside their Waterford West home on Saturday. Two-year-old Darcy and one-year-old Chloe were known to child safety. That is what the Premier has confirmed yesterday. And this review will be independent and external to get to the bottom of exactly what happened. Their mother, Kerri-Anne Conley, is still behind bars. She had her case mentioned here at the Brisbane Magistrates Court yesterday. She's facing two charges of murder, and she's also facing drugs charges, accused of possessing marijuana and a drug pipe on the day that her two little girls passed away. The Child Safety Minister wouldn't comment on this case in particular, but what she's revealed is quite shocking, that one child every 4 minutes is referred to the department here in Queensland. Yeah, Deb?
Just appalling. Jess Millwood, thank you.
A Sydney grandmother will today fight for her life and her freedom in Malaysia's highest court, attempting to overturn her death sentence and conviction for drug trafficking. Nine's Asia correspondent Renee Henry is in Kuala Lumpur with more on this one. Renee, such a crucial day for Maria Exposta.
Well, absolutely. On and off death row for 5 years today, Maria Exposto asked Malaysia's appeals court to not only scrap her death penalty but free her altogether. Her lawyers are confident of having her conviction quashed. They will argue legal technicalities after in 2014, the Sydney grandmother was caught at Kuala Lumpur's International Airport with more than a kilo of crystal meth stitched into a bag. She has always maintained she was the innocent victim of an online romance scam that saw her befriend a stranger who gave her that bag to take to Australia but failed to mention drugs were inside. If they can't get the conviction quashed, lawyers will instead fight to have her death penalty replaced with a life sentence, but admit it will be near impossible. Despite there being potential looming changes to Malaysian law, right now death by hanging is mandatory for drug traffickers. Back to you, Tom.
All right, Renee Henry there in Malaysia. Thank you.
A frantic manhunt is underway for a pair of thieves who got away with more than $1 billion worth of jewels from a museum in Germany. Our Europe correspondent Amelia Adams has more on this. And Amelia, it really is like something out of a Hollywood movie.
Yeah, it has all the makings of it, that is for sure, Deb. And we now have the eerie security vision to go with the story. German police have just released this CCTV. You can see the two men. They have torches, one has an axe, and he smashes over and over, I counted about 8 or 10 times, into this glass cabinet. And inside there, these treasured diamond sets, which are now missing, and they're invaluable, authorities say. They're historically and culturally very, very significant. The building, the Green Vault at Dresden Castle, is supposed to be heavily fortified, but the thieves broke in through a ground floor window. They took an iron grill off the glass, smashed the glass and crawled in and got away with the goods. So there you go. And now, as you say, this manhunt is underway. There's a special task force looking for these thieves. And it is a bit of a race against time, Deb, because the fear is they're so recognisable and famous, these jewels. They don't want them to be broken down or sold on in any way. So manhunt underway right now across Europe.